friends, it's Miss Denise here. I was thinking that we are spending a lot of time at home these days. And if any of you have pets, it gives you some extra time to give them some loving attention and for them to offer you some as well. I know my little cat Lillian is one of my best buddies, and I've been getting to spend a lot of nice quality time with her. Lillian, that's Lillian over there. She's my orange tabby. And I was talking to her earlier, and I thought maybe we could share some ways about care, keeping each other safe and also our pets safe, especially in this time when we're all together for long periods of time. So I have this book called, the title is Tails Are Not for Pulling. Lillian loves this book. So does my dog Gibbs. Tails Are Not for Pulling by Elizabeth Verdick, illustrated by Marijke Heinlein. Oh, that's the same author and illustrator of the book we just read about washing our hands and being sure that we stay safe by keeping our hands clean so that we don't spread germs. You ready, Lillian? Yeah, I think she is. If pets could talk, what do you think they'd say? Woof. Squeak, squeak. Glub, glub. What do we have here? Cat? Oh, okay, you're gonna help me, right? A dog? Mouse? Parrot? That's a type of a bird. And a goldfish in a bowl. But what does that mean? Maybe, fur is for petting. Lillian loves, my cat Lillian loves to be pet gently. Only gently though. Backs are for scratching. Our puppy dogs love their backs and their bellies scratched. Not too hard though. And noses are for nuzzling. I wonder what these are called. What, Lillian? Lillian says these are hamsters. And see the hamster wheel? That's their how they get their exercise, by spinning round and round. And look at where they get their water. And tails are not for pulling. No way, no how. That hurts. Look at all the animals, they're kind of hiding their tails. They're letting you know they don't like their tails pulled, and it's not kind to do that. Sometimes pets get scared. They think you're going to hurt them, even if you don't mean to. Does that puppy dog look happy? He has a little bit of a worried look on his face. Why do you think that is? Watch and listen closely. A pet may try to warn you. Jump. That's a pet's way of saying hands off. So if you hear a growl or a cat lifts up their shoulders and their back and goes, it's because they're frightened. And the only thing they know how to do is scratch or bite. That is how they protect themselves. Pets are for cuddling, not squeezing. Right? We can pet them and cuddle very gently. Pets are for loving, not teasing and pestering them. If you let them come to you, a little kitty cat will purr and be very happy. She might even let you scratch her ears. And don't forget, tails are not for pulling. They're for wagging. That shows that a puppy dog is very happy. The end. Let's see if Lillian enjoyed the book. Lillian, hey, did you enjoy the book? Did you enjoy the book? See, right now, Lillian heard with her ears. She heard the book, but she looks as though she's cleaning her paws and it's her bath time. So she doesn't want to be bothered and I'm not going to bother her. We'll talk to you later, Lil. Okay, see you soon, friends. Ciao.